Good evening, and welcome to Weaver Academy's Theater Senior Showcase. Thank you so much for joining us tonight. Well, seniors, we did this. It's done. It's over. I'll miss you. I'll miss you every day. Congratulations. Mr. Taylor and I are so very proud of each and every one of you. We love you and wish you nothing but the best. Congratulations.
Hi everyone, my name is Allie McLean, and in case you didn't know, I happen to fulfill the position of Haley's best friend. And so I am incredibly honored to be presenting her this year as the 2020 graduating senior. During her time at Weaver Academy, Haley really made her mark in the theater department, performing in roles such as Molly in Ghost the Musical, Bridget in Bring It On the Musical, and Tybalt in Romeo and Juliet, which was actually her favorite production at Weaver. She also starred in the role of ITS president, where I got to work by her side and really learn and like become really good friends with her and learn how determined and passionate and unstoppable this young woman is. Never, I repeat, never underestimate her, because she will surely exceed your expectations. And that's what makes her the most valuable actress, student, and friend. outside of school, Haley also competed in the August Wilson monologue competition, where she won and got to perform on a Broadway stage in New York. All the while, Haley was also a part of the nonprofit organization GPA, where she starred in many roles and also got to do the behind the scenes as a stage manager for Chicago, which she also excelled at. Haley has been the most inspirational person that I have had the opportunity to know. And she has taught me how to work hard for my dreams and goals and know that I am worth it and that I can do anything I set my mind to, because I watched her do just that. And I have a little reminder for you, Haley. Something to just keep in the back of your head as you go to college and future job opportunities. Just always know that you are more than talented enough, and you have so many people rooting for you. And I love you so much, and I will always be your number one fan. Well, right behind your mom, at least. And so, ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Haley Ann Myers, who will be attending Roosevelt University in Chicago in the fall to obtain a BFA in musical theater. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Haley Myers, and this is Meadowlark.
The lark was blind, and an old king came and took her to his palace. Contianus is easily one of the warmest, most kind-hearted people that I've ever gotten the opportunity to meet. She makes everyone feel welcome no matter what, and I know that quality is going to take her so incredibly far. We first met at a theater camp back in 2016, where I didn't know anyone or really know what I was doing, and Alex quickly became such a guiding light for me there, as well as Weaver. She has been such a great example of strength and kindness for me, as well as perseverance, and I am eternally grateful for that. Alex, I'm going to miss you so much, but I'm so incredibly proud of how far you've come. I know you are going to do amazing things, and we are all so, so proud of you. Heading to Appalachian State University, Alexandra Contianus.
Hi, my name is Alex Contianus, and I will be performing two monologues. The first being from Titus Andronicus, written by William Shakespeare in the character of Tamora, and the second being from the Less Than Human Club, written by Timothy Mason in the character of Kirsten. Stay, Roman brethren. Gracious conqueror, victorious Titus, rue the tears I shed, a mother's tears in passion for her son. And if thy sons were ever dear to thee, think my son to be as dear to me. Sufficeth not that we are brought to Rome to beautify thy triumphs and return captive to thee in thy Roman yoke, but must my sons be slaughtered in the streets for valiant doings in their country's cause? Oh, if to fight for king and commonweal were piety in thine, it is in these. Andronicus, stain not thy tomb with blood. Wilt thou draw near the nature of the gods? Draw near them then, in being merciful. Sweet mercy is nobility's true badge. Thrice noble Titus, spare my firstborn son. Wow. You're a wonderful dancer. I mean, where did you learn to dance like that? You never go to school dances. My dad, he's such a great guy, you know? I mean, he helps me out with so much. He's a little quiet, though. He's a mailman. They tend to be quiet letter carriers. I don't think people generally realize that. If you want to go, Davis, I'll understand. I mean, I know you're thinking this was a mistake, and you're a kind person, and you always have been, but I'll understand. My dad, he was so nervous tonight, you know, I mean, you'd think he'd be the one going on to a dance. He was a little proud, too, but mostly just nervous. Did he give you the old third degree while I was upstairs? No, okay. I think my dad is a lot more like Pumper's dad than Bambi's dad, because Bambi's dad is like this great big old stag, and then he's the king of the forest, and my dad is like an old rabbit. Thank you.
Okay, so when I was first coming up with this, it was hard to find the words. But the more and more that I thought about the times and the memories that I've shared and laughed with her, the words came a lot easier. Shania arrived in this department her sophomore year, just like me. So there was already something that, you know, we could relate to. But when I first met Shania, I mean, we had clicked, like, super fast. I mean, she has this personality, or, you know, this aura about her that, like, when you're around her, I mean, you know that you know, you're either going to laugh or that you're going to have a good time or something's about to happen. And, you know, if you didn't know her already, some people might be afraid starting out, especially if you see her and all of her friends just dying laughing for no reason at all, running halfway across the entire school for no reason. But, you know, that's just the type of people we are and the type of person she is. And it's pretty funny. But she's very welcoming and she really helped me feel comfortable and more connected to the department whenever I first started out, which I'm sure she's done for other people in the department as well, and, you know, help them get through a lot of stuff. Now, Shania has called me brother on multiple occasions, and to be honest, for the longest time, I didn't feel like I deserved that title from her. But, you know, as, you know, time went on, I learned to accept it and our tiny little family that we have in the theater department. I'm super proud of her. And I'm also really happy that both me and her landed amazing roles this year in the plays. She really deserved it. And Shania's always gonna mean like a sister to me, and I'm sure she'll always feel like a family to our department as well. I'm super proud of her, and I'm gonna miss her a lot. But I know it's not goodbye, so I'm just gonna say, I can't wait till we hang out again. Heading to Clark Atlanta University, Shania Burnett.
Tashiana Potts has been one of the most positive influences to me and many others while at Weaver Academy. She led the costume crew with compassion and diligence, to which I know she will carry with her to college. Tosh will be missed by everyone in the Weaver Academy Theater Department, especially the ones that had the pleasure of working with her. Costume crew wasn't just a crew, it was a family. I'm going to especially miss the jokes and cries we had backstage together. Tosh put her passion and hard work into everything she does. Working and learning from Tosh has been one of the greatest gifts that I could ever receive. Thank you, Tosh, for leading the costume crew with your love and passion for costuming. I hope we can make you proud. I know she is going to do great in college, and I hope to see her work shining brightly in the future. Heading to Meredith College, Tashiana Potts.
Hello, my name is Tashiana Potts, and I will be showing the creation of a silk satin dress. Thank you.
Thank you. my name is Nora Shearer, and I'm introducing Rivers Johnson. Rivers and I got really close when we were in Romeo and Juliet together, and she kind of took me under her wing because I was just this little baby freshman and I didn't really know anybody. And not only has she become a mentor for me, but she is one of the best friends I've ever had. I mean, we could always talk to each other, and I would go out to her car after rehearsal, and we would talk, and we would go get food, and she would put up with all of the stupid stuff that I would do in public. And there's so much that I admire about her. I mean, she's not afraid to be a leader. She's not afraid to be herself. She's kind, compassionate, she's funny, and everything that she puts her mind to, she puts so much passion and hard work into it. I remember she got the lead for Frankenstein, and we went out to her car, and I looked through the script, and she just had so much to do. There are so many lines, so much to memorize, and I swear, not even a week later, she was fully memorized. Ever since she got the lead and she got the script in her hands, she was on 100% of the time. She put her all into that show, and I don't know how I'm going to survive junior year without her, but heading to Appalachian State University is Rivers Johnson.
Hi, my name is Rivers Johnson, and today I'll be performing two monologues. The first will be from The Pillow Man in the character of Katurian, and the second will be from The Merchant of Venice in the character of Shylock. Thank you. I am a little scared, you know. I'm a little scared that my brother is all alone in a strange place, and I'm a little scared that your friend is going to go and kick the crap out of him and then come back here and kick the crap out of me again, although if he does, it's okay. I mean, I'd prefer if he didn't, but if there's something about these stories that upsets you, then go ahead and take it out on me. That's fine, but my brother gets frightened very easily, and he's got nothing to do with these stories anyways. I've only ever read them to him, so I think you need to go down there and get him out right now. You call me a misbeliever, cutthroat dog, and spit upon my Jewish gaberdine, and all for the use of that which is mine own. You would come to me, and you would say, Shylock, we would have monies, you who did void your room upon my beard, and foot me over your threshold as you would a stranger cur. Monies is your suit. And what shall I say to you? Shall I not say half a dog monies? Is it possible a cur can lend 3,000 ducats, or shall I bend low with an abodman's key and with bated breath say to you, fair sir, you spat on me Wednesday last. Another day such you spurned me, you called me dog, and for these courtesies I'll lend you thus much monies. Rivers Johnson.
Hi, I'm Sophia Crompton, and I have the opportunity to do Annie Conrad's senior video. Annie has been one of my best friends and someone I've looked up to the past couple of years. To know Annie is to know joy. She is so determined and hardworking and puts her all in everything she does. I remember there'd be times at lunch where she'd be working on lines the entire time or going into the theater to work on costumes and just making sure that everything she's responsible for is done and is done well. Annie is super selfless and kind and is a great friend. She's provided me many words of encouragement and wisdom over the past couple of years. She also does so much for the department. Whether she's up on stage or working on costumes or doing hair and makeup, she puts her all in everything she does. I'm so excited to see everything Annie does in life. Annie, thank you for all of our memories, from you cutting my hair in the parking lot, to our two-person Super Bowl party, to you letting me third wheel, and to our debates on what color my eyes actually are. I am going to miss you tremendously next year, but I am super excited to see what you do and all the big things you'll accomplish in life. Headed to East Carolina University, Annie Conrad.
My name is Annie Conrad, and I will be singing Breathe by Cumin and Diamond.
My name is Sarah Stevens, and I would like to introduce a senior who has been there to help me since my freshman orientation. And for the 3 years we've been in school together, I've learned so much. He he has even been there to help answer the unnecessary questions about lighting I constantly had, or help make up lighting cues on the spot for one of the more difficult shows we've worked on. He's always been there to help me and the department, working long hours, even on weekends, to get everything perfect for the shows. He has proven himself to be excellent at whatever he tries, whether that is on stage, in the booth, or behind the camera. I will miss the nonsense, random dance parties, and snack breaks in the booth. Not only has he been great to work with as a peer, but as a friend who I could always go to for advice or rant to. But I know that won't end as he goes to do amazing things in college. Heading to UNCSA, Alex Lucas Fritz.
If a bird clapped its wings every time it sang, it would fly an entire lifetime. Every chirp equates a flap, and every flap equates movement in the air, his wings slicing through the air, fighting gravity and creating movement. The movement is a force. It's a force in the sky. And if he clapped his wings every time he sang, the sky would surrender. But it won't. I wish I were like the sky. A memory reaches my lips, slips the cracks and spills upon the table. Images form visual recollections. My eyes reflect the distances I feel, and streaks of regret fall closer to the ground. The memory nears my heart. Here it is reclaimed, reimagined, and felt. Words slip the cracks through which memory escaped. The redolent memory exposes a face etched in memory. A face that was seen every day, but it slowly dissipates as I chuckle, thinking of that face and what it means to me. His heart has grown restless. It has been for a while. Yet he finds solace in the memories that he has made with his family, with his friends, and with his mentors. But he also finds solace in hope. Hope allows him to heal over time, and with time, that hope will grow stronger.
Hi, my name is Ada Collins, and today I have the privilege to honor one of my biggest role models, Danielle. So, I first met Danielle when we started working together on 33 Variations. She was the stage manager, and I was one of the assistant stage managers. And I'm not gonna lie, I was pretty nervous. It was the first show that I had ever done at Weaver, and I was afraid that I was gonna disappoint her, because I was so new. But Danielle welcomed me in with so much encouragement and love and positivity, and she taught me so much throughout that whole experience. She taught me what it means to be a strong leader and how to be respectful, and she taught me how to drill. Really appreciate that one. But that just proves how much of a crucial addition she is to the theater department. She is one of the most hardworking people in the theater PVA, and I feel so honored that she, like, kind of served as, like, a mentor for me. I have no doubt that I wouldn't be where I am right now if it wasn't for her. Danielle is special in that she made, like, an effort to cultivate a professional relationship with me, but also to, like, make a friend. She would always say hi to me in the hallways, and she always helps me whenever I'm feeling down or am confused or whatnot. And I'm having a hard time, like, coming up with the words to express what a wonderful person Danielle is. I'm not gonna lie, I'm pretty nervous to go into my sophomore year without her because she was such a huge rock for me and like helping me throughout my freshman year. But on the other hand, she's also like set me up for success. She has provided me the tools that I need to continue on as a strong individual. And I am so incredibly grateful for you, Danielle. And I'm sorry that I can't find the words to express how much you mean to me, but I cannot wait to see you do such wonderful things in the future. I love you so, so, so much, and yeah, thank you for everything. Heading to Greensboro College, Danielle Akins.
Hi, my name is Danielle Akins, and I'll be performing a monologue from the play Fences by August Wilson in the character of Rose. You can't be nobody but who you are, Corey. That shadow is nothing but you growing into yourself. Now you either gotta grow into it or cut it down to fit you, but that's all you got to make life with. That's all you got to measure yourself up against that world out there. Now, your daddy wanted you to be everything he was and at the same time tried to make you into everything he wasn't. Now, I don't know if he was right or wrong, but I do know he meant to do more good than he did harm. Okay, he wasn't always right. And sometimes when he touched, he bruised. And sometimes when he took me into his arms, he cut. When I first met your daddy, I thought, now here's a man I can lay down and make a baby with. That was the first thing I thought when I seen him. I was 30 years old at the time, and I had done seen my fair share of men. But when he walked up to me and said, I could dance a waltz that'll make you dizzy, I thought, Rosalie, here's a man that you could open yourself up to be filled to bursting. Here's a man that could fill all those empty faces that you've been tipping around the edges of. And baby, one of those empty spaces is being somebody's mother. I married your father and I set her down to cooking his supper and keeping clean sheets on the bed. When your father walked in the house, he was so big he filled it. That was my first mistake in the matter. Not to make him leave some room for me, for my part in the matter. But at the time, I wanted that. I wanted a house I could sing in, and that's what your daddy gave me. Now, I didn't know I would have to give little pieces of myself to keep up with this strength. I did that. I took on his life, his mind, and I mixed with the pieces so much that you could hardly tell which was which anymore. It was my choice, it was my life, and I didn't have to live it that way. But that's what life offered in the way of being a woman, and I took it. I grabbed hold of it with both hands. Now, by the time Rondell came into the world, me and your daddy had done lost touch with one another. Now, I don't want to make my blessings off of nobody's misfortune, but I took on Rondell as she had been all them babies I had wanted but never had. Like I'd been blessed to relive a part of my life. And if the Lord sees fit to keep up my strength, I'm going to do her just like your daddy did you. I'm going to give her the best of what's in me. Thank you.
So, the beginning of my freshman year, I sat next to Frances Porter at NCTC. We connected almost instantly, and no friendship of mine up to that point had ever felt so easy. If you ask anyone in the department, I'm sure that they would say the same. Frances Porter offers so much love and overwhelming kindness and energy. She is a friend to all that she meets. This kindness that she offers is never selfish and always genuine. It is truly a blessing to watch Frances perform. She offers truth to a scene, never fake or overdone. Her empathy for others makes all of the characters she plays understandable and relatable. Frances is a person that is truly unforgettable. She is going to be one of those people that I remember 10 years from now for the incredible friendship and guidance she's given to me. When things are tough and hard for me and many others to go through, she brings lightheartedness and support to help you get through it. Weaver will not be the same without her. I speak for the whole department in saying she will be missed, and we are all so proud of her and all of her accomplishments. I am grateful every day to call her a friend. So to one of the most incredible people I've ever met, heading to Brooklyn College, Frances Porter, we all love you so much. Break a leg.
Hi, Hi, my name is Frances Porter, and today I will be performing a monologue from the play Lobby Hero in the character of Dawn. Thank you.
I mean, yeah, I guess generally they're proud of me, sure. I was near the top of my class at the academy. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I just messed up with this guy. And now I'm screwed. It's just these guys, you know? I mean, these guys, they walk around like they don't care about anything, right? And so you gotta walk around like you don't care about anything either. But they know you still do. And so they like try to stamp it out of you or something and like test you all the time. And you know, they can say, you're not men, you're not women, you're cops. Right? And if you act like a cop, you'll be treated like a cop, right? But then you find out that they all have a pool going for who's gonna sleep with you first, and that's fine. I mean, it's not... I can handle that. But then, somebody decent comes along. And like, goes out of his way to make life easier for you. Like, I didn't ask him because I didn't expect anything different. I didn't want anything different. And it's like, oh my God. True love.
Hello, everyone. At this time, I have the privilege of introducing someone who means so very much to me, and I know means so very much to so many others within this theater department. And back in 2019, March, when I started to spend a lot of time with Trinity, I noticed that she had some moments where, you know, maybe she hadn't thought through the things she was saying, as we all do. We all have those moments. I know I certainly do. But Trin's brought me a lot of joy and a lot of laughter, and I decided that I never wanted to forget some of the things that she said. So I've been looking for an excuse to share some of these quotations by Miss Trinity Evans with a large group of people. And although I can't hear any reactions, I trust that you all get as much enjoyment out of these as I always have. I'm not saying that Trin is not bright for saying these things, because we all have those moments. She's one of the smartest people, one of the most passionate people I know, but I just need to be heard. Okay, so on April 19th of 2019, there was a delivery woman that came to Trinity's house, and it was a package for Trin, so she was excited. She ran out there, and Trin came in and told us that the delivery woman had told her, "I need your John Hancock." And Trin said, "I'm sorry, that's not me." And next up was backstage at one of the shows of Ghost the Musical. And I was talking to Trin backstage, and I told her that my dad is from Connecticut, to which she responded, "Louisiana?" And she corrected herself on all of these, trust me. On June 17th, 2019, she tried to pour a whole water bottle through the straw of a Yeti cup until that she noticed, well, that there's a more efficient way. Put the lid off. Okay, and then my personal favorite, I need this paper to get these quotes word for word, was on April 23rd, 2019, when we were discussing our school trip to London, and she said, "So what happens if you drive to London?" Wait, you can't do that. It's classic, and I don't ever want to forget these memories, so I had to make myself a little tab. Now, I'm so thankful for Trinity and all that she's done for me and done for so many others. I admire her positivity so much. She can always find the good in a situation and make comments like this that just brighten people's day, or brighten mine at least. And I know I've watched her light up Mr. Taylor's face with a funny comment, or just doing her best to make him feel better, or Miss Croc, and the others around us. And I think we're all very lucky to have someone like Trin. So, attending the North Carolina, she's staying here, guys. No, attending the New York Conservatory for Dramatic Arts next year, we have Miss Trinity Evans.
Hi, my name is Trinity Evans.
I'm Stephanie Evans.
And today we will be performing History of Wrong Guys.
From Kinky Boots.
Thank you.
From outer space, who's that bright-eyed guy in your place? You're kinda cute when you're not so shy. Ow. But I've been here before. Have I come back for more? Another chapter in the history of wrong guys. You used to be so a lip lackluster bore, but now you're changing.
Hey, Elena. Ignore this ghost of me, right? I don't know what that's about. Anyway, wow. Okay, so. This girl is one of my closest friends in the department, and I am so blessed and so grateful to have gotten to know her over these past 3 years. Helena is so talented in so many ways. She's not only an incredible actress, she's also consistently a leader in the sound world and always takes on the hardest tasks whenever we're doing set building in class, even if that means getting yelled at. Bring it on, backdrop. Sorry. This year, she also even wrote and directed an amazing play that was set to go to ITS Festival. It's crazy. The girl is literally always working and always serving this department. She's also shown me and everyone who knows her what it means to be strong in the face of adversity, to always speak your mind and stand up for what you believe in, to try and see the light even when you're in a dark place, and to be so, so driven in everything you set your mind to. Thanks for everything, Lena. I believe in you, and I know you can accomplish amazing things. Heading to High Point University for pre-law, Helena Franco! Woo!
Hi, my name's Helena Franco, and I'll be doing two monologues, the first from Steel Magnolias in the character Shelby, and the second from An American Worker in the character Deb. Mama, I don't know why you have to be so difficult about everything all the time. I see this baby as the opportunity of a lifetime. Sure, there's risk involved, but that's true with anybody. But at the end of the day, you get up, and there's a piece of immortality with Jackson's looks and with my sense of style, I hope. Mama, please, I need your support. I would rather have 30 minutes of wonderful than a lifetime of nothing special. You see this? You don't get off the drugs and start being the man that I married, then I'm gonna do something awful. I'm gonna kill the baby. Kill your baby. Kill my baby. Kill him and kill myself in the process because you don't deserve nothing. Nothing at all. You hear me? Now you gonna stop with this nonsense or what? Because you ain't no drugged out loser, Brian. You are a winner. At least you was. You just have to get back to that man again. You remember what you said to me? You ain't ever gonna have to worry about nothing, Deb, because I'm an American worker. I'm a man of steel, so don't count me out, but now look at you. You're down for the count. But it don't have to be this way, Brian. You can be that man again. You just have to want to. You hear me? You just have to want to be that man again. Now tell me, what's it gonna be? Or I'm gonna shove this knife in our baby and you ain't gonna have nothing. Nothing in this world for the rest of your life but blood on your hands. Helena Franco.
Hi, my name is Courtney Rouse. I am a current junior. I officially met this senior on the first day of freshman year. She's a sophomore at the time. I say officially because we had been interacting on Instagram over the summer between 8th grade and freshman year. As a matter of fact, she was the first upperclassman to talk to me and make me feel welcomed at Weaver. She invited me to sit with her and her friends at lunch until I found my own group of friends to sit with. And Weaver may be a small school, but finding friends on the first day of school is pretty hard. This made her stick out among the crowd of upperclassmen. Even when I found my own group of friends, she still managed to speak to me every time we saw each other in the hallway. She uplifted me. She was so sweet and nice. And no matter what, she always knew what to say and when to say it. If she had a superpower, I guess it was mind reading because, once again, she always knew what to say somehow. This senior is truly one of the sweetest people I know, if not the sweetest person I know. And not to mention, she's hilarious. And she's not like just kind of funny. Like, she is funny without even meaning to be funny. Like, she is that funny. And I wish I had more time to get to know her. And I'll never forget that night that we went to IHOP after A Christmas Story. She made me laugh so hard, and I'm sure the whole restaurant heard me. Even in the midst of a pandemic, she has still managed to stay optimistic and kind to those around her. She's the gem that you truly only meet once in a lifetime, and I'm so grateful for her to be in my life. She may not know it, but she is truly a shining light in the lives of those around her, and she's one of the people that I look up to. My words to you in the future are, set your sail and use the winds of life to guide you wherever you want to go. Even though she's leaving us, she isn't going very far. Thank God, I don't know what I would do without her. So without further ado, heading to UNCG, Tiana Williams.
Such a huge part of my Weaver experience. As a freshman this year, I was very nervous to come to a new school and have to make new friends, but she was one of the first friends that I made. Julia is my senior parent, and she's been so nice and kind to me, and I can't thank her enough for that. She answered all the questions that I have and even gave me some gifts. I remember someone said she's like the older version of me. I think that's just because of the brown hair and the bangs, but I wish that were true because I would be lucky to be half as amazing as her in just 3 years. She's the sweetest and most genuine person I know, and that's only after a year. If she means this much to me now, I can't imagine how much she means to her fellow ensemble members. I'm so glad she picked me to be her freshman child, because she's the best senior parent I could have ever imagined. Heading to UNC Wilmington, Julia Murray.
Hi, my name is Julia Murray, and I'll be performing a monologue from the play Tiny Beautiful Things by Nia Vardalos in the character of Letter Writer Number 2. I got pregnant, and my boyfriend and me, we were really excited to become parents. When I was 6.5 months pregnant, I miscarried. And since then, just not a day has gone by where I haven't thought about who that child would have been. You know, a girl. And sometimes I wake up and I think my daughter would be 6 months old, or my daughter would maybe have started crawling today. Sometimes all I wake up and hear is the word daughter, just over and over and over again. And I'm not sad or pissed off. I just don't feel anything. I'm numb and I can't get past it. See, all the people in my life have just expected me to move on by now. Shit, one even pointed out it was only a miscarriage. So now I feel bad about being just so stuck. Just grieving for a child that never was. And the rational part of me understands that if I don't pull myself out of this, I'm gonna do some serious damage to myself. I know this, and yet I just don't care. I want to know how to care again. Thank you.
At my first pizza social, I was this terrified little kid. I didn't know anyone, and I didn't really feel like I belonged just yet. I ended up finding Rachel's wallet, and so I look at her license to give it back to her, and I'm like, who is this beautiful blonde person? And I was kind of intimidated, but I couldn't have been any more wrong. Rachel made me feel so welcomed and like I finally had a place. She treats everyone with love and kindness and makes them feel welcome. She makes everybody feel valid and accepted, and we need more of that in this world. She is this ray of sunshine who is just filled with positivity. And I know she brings light to so many people's lives. Rachel is hardworking and dedicated, and she puts her all into everything that she does. She will put others before herself, and she is so organized. Like, I really, really do look up to her. Rachel has been an amazing role model for me these past 2 years, acting as like this big sister figure that I never got to have. She's helped me through hard times, and her guidance has been priceless to me. Rachel, I know you're going to do amazing things. The world is your oyster, and anything you put your mind to, I know you will be able to do it. Thank you so much for being my mom. Headed to Meredith College, Rachel Montgomery.
A.D. Chang'an, the cosmopolitan heart of the Tang Empire, the remnants of a vanquished Central Asian kingdom, have infiltrated the world's largest city for a planned attack during the Lantern Festival. The Longest Day in Chang'an is a period drama that takes place during the cultural height of the Tang Dynasty that follows the head of Chang'an's anti-terror department and a detective-turned-prisoner who must work together to stop a mysterious army that has infiltrated the empire's capital. I chose to study the costume design of this show for my senior showcase project. It is by far one of the most historically accurate period dramas centered on the Tang Dynasty in China. Extensive research and detail went into every piece of this show. I wanted to study the Tang Dynasty since it was such a remarkable hub of cultural growth and diversity, and its styles remain prominent today. Women's fashion during the Tang Dynasty has some of the most intricate and beautiful clothing. It focused heavily on bright colors and elaborate patterns, and more preparation went into getting dressed each day than modern women can imagine. There are a handful of prominent garments that can be seen in most outfits during this time. Most women wore a combination of a bonbi and ruqin. A daxiu shan was also popular among China's royal women. During this time, outfits became much more of an indicator of status, and distinct differences can be seen between royal dress and commoners. Tang fashion developed throughout the dynasty from simple, conservative dress to a defined style of bright colors and patterns. Women experienced unprecedented freedom during this time, and it can be seen in relatively revealing clothing. The U-shaped neckline was a major change, as well as sheer fabrics that could show the entire silhouette of a woman's body. Women were able to freely display arms and legs during this period as well. Fabrics also featured patterns with fish, flowers, dragons, and other animals. Men's fashion during this time varied. Most men wore a basic Hanfu style, and soldiers wore an interesting amalgamation of armor. The Hanfu style is timeless. During the Tang Dynasty, discrimination against other areas decreased, and clothing from other places such as Persia became intermingled with Chinese dress. Loose, comfortable clothing was popular during this time period. Multiple layers were also used, an underlayer, an inner layer, and an overcoat. Patterns were also common on men's clothes, but their outfits tended to be a singular, solid color with one or two accents, in opposition to the multicolored outfits of women. These colors and patterns were also status symbols. Many men during the Tang Dynasty also wore black kerchiefs over their hair. Tang armor was a collage of multiple times and places. While a large amount of the armor in the show is Ming Wang armor, or lamellar armor, Chinese soldiers also collected armor from defeated enemies, such as suits of iron armor. Many officers could be seen in light armor made of small, interlocked plates, and helmets that extended past the cheekbones. During the later years of the Tang Dynasty, cavalry soldiers were replaced by infantry soldiers due to their heavy armor being too much of a burden on their horses. In conclusion, The Longest Day in Chang'an mirrors Tang Dynasty clothing with spectacular accuracy. The months spent creating props and costumes before filming started truly show. The immersive environment and elaborate setting truly shine through. This show honors the diversity and cultural richness of Chinese history and should be looked to as a shining example for future period pieces.
First off, I want to congratulate Alana on all of her accomplishments she's made throughout her 4 years at Weaver. Congratulations, Alana. I wrote something, so I'm just gonna read it. I can honestly say that Alana has a special place in my heart. Personally, she's a wonderful role model for the African-American girls in our department. She's strong, so talented, with a beautiful, bursting personality. When I first got to know her, my first impression was that she was obviously so talented, but I could also experience her deep love and passion for theater. Eventually, that fire she possessed drove me to accomplish and thrive in the theater program too. I'm so grateful I got the opportunity to experience and enjoy top-tier acting from her. And one thing I like about Alana is that she has this go-getter attitude. And what I mean by that is that she's willing and able to do anything from acting her butt off to giving great advice and making a great thing happen. She gives the department flavor, good energy, and she's definitely one to make you laugh and have a good time with. There's never a dull moment with her. Alana, I appreciate from the bottom of my heart everything you've taught me. Your encouragement, your laughter, and our adventures together. I'm definitely gonna miss you. Alana, I encourage you to strive and continue to be a beacon of light to other people. Inspire, create, and keep perfecting your craft. Don't be discouraged. Keep your head up and remember who you are, how much you've grown, and the people you've impacted. Watching, learning, and feeding off of your energy has been an amazing experience that I will never forget. I thank the man above for you. You are so beautiful, talented. Always remember that. I'm going to miss you so much. Oh gosh. Heading to AMDA in New York City, Alana Walker.
Hi, my name is Alana Walker. I'll be singing The Easiest Life from Aida. This is the moment when the gods expect me to beg for help. But I won't even try. I want nothing in this world but myself. Protect me, and I won't lie down, roll over and die. All I have to do is forget how much I love him. All I have to do is put my longing to one side. Into my heart.
have lost him when the ties were barely binding. That if the contempt of the familiar cannot start, it's easy until I think about him as he was when I last touched him, and how he would have been were I to be with him today. Those very real patients don't let up, they keep on coming, and all I ever wanted, and I'm throwing it away. It's
today I have the honor in telling you all about Dalia Troxer Tucker. Now, me and Dalia go way back, since elementary school through Girl Scouts. That's right. But our friendship began to shift once I came to Weaver. For me, Dalia has made a prominent impact in my life that I'll never forget. For example, I like to see Dalia as my school mom, or at least a substitute for my big sister who goes to a different high school. This is because she's always concerned about my well-being whenever we see each other, and she's always going the extra mile in any way for me. One of my favorite memories with Dalia is talking to her with my sister at the end of the day in her car and spilling the tea or just talking about the crazy things that happened at Weaver. She made me feel accepted and not just the younger sister that had to tag along with her older sister. Throughout the department, Dalia has shared her talent, humor, honesty, and kindness with everyone, which is unforgettable. Not to mention her impeccable fashion sense. We will definitely miss her snacks and drinks for $1 business, but we will most importantly miss Dalia herself. We wish you the best of luck. Heading to GTCC, Dalia Troxler Tucker.
Hi, my name is Dalia Tucker, and I'll be doing a poem written by myself and my mother, Reverend Lakeisha Tucker, entitled Black is Beautiful. To those who say black isn't beautiful, it clearly was a lie. I wonder if that's why they wanted to deny us the simple things like looking at the sky. We have judged each other in more ways than one. Looking at each other's wide nose, keen lips, and different hues of skin, maybe, just maybe, that is where our problem really began. We have become inventors built on adversity's back. Being black, there was no room to slack. Our melanin can be quite unsettling. But you can't deny that our broken pieces have been crafted together like a beautiful mosaic butterfly. One may ask, how can you be so happy after all you've been through? We thought what we did would have killed you. Everything you ever told us was a lie, and nothing you said will ever apply to the joy that I feel down in my soul. We took those words and we used them as coal. We've been pressed down, but our prayers have been raised up. I can see them rising like beautiful buttercups. So, for those who still say, our black isn't beautiful. It's simple. Our melanin is genuine. So we won't stop rising. We won't stop shining. We won't stop grinding. And we won't stop deciding to be the kings and queens that we were created to be. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Mira Eby, and I'm really happy to be doing Bronwyn Bradshaw's senior video. Bronwyn has been such an influential person in my life for the past few years. I remember coming to see Urinetown at Weaver when I was 11 years old and just being in complete awe the entire time. And the second Bronwyn walked on stage, I could not take my eyes off her. And there was just, I was so blown away by her captivating spirit. And those were some of the moments that I realized that I wanted to be up there and I wanted to do what they were doing and I wanted to start doing theater, so I'm really grateful for that. When my dad started doing gigs with her, she just instantly felt like family. There was never an awkward or even kind of uncomfortable moment, even before I really knew her, and she's just the queen of making people feel comfortable being themselves, and I really, really admire her for that. To call her talented is an understatement. She has so much passion for every single thing she does, and when she goes for something, she just really, really goes for it. And she's just one of those people you're so thankful you ran into. And though every person is unique, there are always some who will, for whatever reason, stand out as you move through life. And Bronwyn is 100% one of those people for me. It's been truly amazing to watch her become the incredibly driven, witty, audacious, intelligent, and beautiful woman she is, and I'm so grateful to have her as a big sister figure in my life. I can't wait to see her take on her next chapter by storm. Heading to Emerson College in Boston, Bronwyn Bradshaw.
He don't wanna know me, says he made the biggest mistake dancing in my snow. Said it was poison. Guess I'll go home into the arms of a brother love. The only love I have was screwed up. She's so hard to please, but she's a forest fire. I do my best to meet her demands, play up on my ass, but slow dance in the living room. Stranger would see this one girl swaying alone, stroking her cheek. They say you're a little much for me. You're a liability. You're a little much for me. Say they pull back, make other plans. I understand I'm a liability. Get you out. Don't work anymore. Let me get bored with me. No, it's exciting running through the night when every perfect summer's eating me alive until you're gone. Better on my own.
Hey guys, congratulations on making it through your senior year despite all of the craziness. I'm so happy I got to be a part of your high school experience, and I miss you guys. And I know that you guys are all going to do amazing things in the coming years because you've worked so hard. And I hope you guys have an amazing summer, and congratulations.
Hi, I'm Shania Burnett, and I'll be doing a monologue from For Colored Girls in the character of the Lady in Red. Without any assistance or guidance from you, I've loved you assiduously for 8 months, 2 weeks, and a day. I've left 7 packages on your doorstep, 40 poems, 3 plants, 2 handmade note cards. I left town so that I could send to you. You've been of no assistance on my job. You'd call me at 3 o'clock in the morning so that I could drive 27 and a half miles across the bay to come get you before I went to work. Charming, charming. But you have been of no assistance. I want to let you know that this was an experiment to see how selfish I could really be, to see if I could really carry on to snare a possible lover, to see if I was capable of debasing myself for the love of another, to see if I could stand not being wanted when I wanted to be wanted and I cannot. So, without any assistance or guidance from you, I'm ending this affair. This note is attached to a plant that I've been watering since the day I've met you. You may water it yourself. Shanee Burnett.
Hi guys, I miss you a lot, and I'm so proud of you guys for getting through all of what's been happening and still putting together amazing performances for the senior showcase. I really wish the senior showcase could have gone on as usual and I could have seen all of you and hugged all of you, because some of you I haven't seen in like a year, which doesn't feel right. And yeah, I just love you guys all so much, and you're all so incredibly talented. I've been looking at all of the schools you guys are going to, and you guys are insane, and you're gonna do amazing stuff in the future. I love you guys.
Hi, my name is Annie Conrad.
Hello, my name is Trinity Evans,
and today we will be singing For Good from Wicked.
But before we get started, I just wanted to say a few words to Ms. Croc. You have been such an inspiration to me for this past 4 years. I thank you for all your support and love and effort and faith that you've put into me and the rest of the ensemble. I've no clue what I'm gonna do without you. I was not ready to leave Weaver. Yeah, I just wanted to say thank you, and this song is for you.
A stream that meets a boulder halfway through.
I just wanted to say thank you so much for everything you've done for me and for everyone in our ensemble. We just love you so much, and thank you for putting your trust in me for throughout the years through all of the shows that we've done together. And I've just learned so much from you, not only as an actress but as a person, and I love you a lot. And even though our time was cut short, I appreciated every second of it, and I can't wait for our paths to cross again in the future. Love you.
Hi, ensemble. It's Jack. I miss you guys so much. I just wanted to say congratulations. I know this is the most... This situation is very not ideal to have the senior showcase in, but nonetheless, you're all so wonderful and so gorgeous and so freaking talented, and I'm so grateful that I got to see you guys grow since day one, which, by the way, I still remember vividly that first week freshman year when we all learned constructive rest and we couldn't stop laughing, which might not be a good example because we would probably still laugh today, or at least I would. Anyways, the point is, I'm so, so happy and proud of all of you, and I'm so excited to see all the trails you blaze in your college endeavors. I love you all. Goodbye.
Kiss today, goodbye. The sweetness and the sorrow. Wish me luck the same to you. But I can't regret what I did for love, what I did for love. Look, my eyes are dry. The gift was ours to borrow. Oh, it's as if we forget what I did for love, what I did for love. Gone, love is never gone. As we travel on, love's what we to for love. What I did for love. Today.